Hello, and welcome to dbForge Studio for MySQL tutorial. In this video, we will learn how to manage MySQL user accounts and their access privileges from dbForge Studio for MySQL. MySQL user security comes in a few different layers. To give someone access to a MySQL instance, first, we must create a user account for that user. The user account is made up of two parts: the actual username and the hosts the user can connect from. This is different from traditional user accounts we see in other database systems. In MySQL, we create a user by specifying the username, followed by an @ symbol, followed by the host address. We also specify a password for the user account. This allows the user to connect to the MySQL instance from that host. Sometimes, however, we want the user to be able to connect from any host. In these cases, we use a percent sign to denote any host. When a user tries to connect to a MySQL instance, the user specifies the username, including the host address, and a password. If MySQL can't find the username and its host name, connection is refused. If the username and its host name exist, but the password is incorrect, the connection is also refused. If the username and the password are correct, MySQL allows the connection. After the user connects to the database instance and tries to perform any action, MySQL checks the account's privileges. If the user has the required privilege, the action is successful. Otherwise, an error is returned. There are a few different types of privileges we can define for a user account. For example, the privilege to connect to one or more databases and access data. The privilege to create, modify, or drop database objects. The privilege to change MySQL config parameters or perform other system-level operations. The privilege to create other user accounts, and so on. To see how these all work, let's connect to a MySQL instance and see the user accounts and their privileges. Here, we are connected to a remote MySQL instance from our local workstation. This instance is running in an Amazon EC2 server. We are running a select statement against the user table. As you can see, our query returns a list of usernames and host names. Some of the users can connect from any host. Some are allowed access from the instance only. We can also see a user called root. The root or master user is the most powerful MySQL user. It's a built-in account and has system-wide privileges. The root user can practically do anything on the instance, including creating other user accounts. To manage security, the root user can create different types of users, such as ordinary users with read-only access to one or more databases, advanced users with write access to those databases, and power users with rights to create or modify objects in those databases. In this terminal, we have connected to the MySQL instance as test user. This user doesn't have access to the MySQL system database. Let's try to run a query on the database. In this query, test user is trying to see the structure of the user table. As you can see, the error message says the user doesn't have select privilege on the table. To see the privileges granted to a user, we can run the show grants command, followed by the username. Let's see what rights test user has. We go to the previous screen and run the command. The output now shows the access privileges for test user. Let's say we are the database administrator and we want to grant this user access to the MySQL database. We can run a command like this to grant select permission on any table in the MySQL database. Let's go back to the test user's terminal. If we now run the same query as before, it succeeds. All these user security related operations in MySQL can be done in an intuitive way from dbForge Studio for MySQL. Using a tool like dbForge Studio saves you from remembering the commands and typing them repeatedly. Of course, you can run the SQL commands there as well, but the graphical interface is much easier to use. To manage MySQL user accounts from dbForge Studio for MySQL, select the Database menu and then Security Manager. This opens the Security Manager screen. At the top of the screen, we can see the connection we have selected. Below this, we have a folder for users. You can see there are two folders under it. One is a person sign, the other is localhost. These folders represent different hosts users can connect from. If we expand the person folder, we can see different user accounts. These are the users who can connect to the MySQL instance from any host. If we expand the localhost folder, we can see some system level users, including the root user. These users can connect only from the host itself. Let's see the properties of an existing user. We select the user 6 account. From the general tab, we can see the username is user 6 and it can connect from any host. It has a password and the password is configured never to expire. As a security best practice, you should ensure non-system accounts have a password expiration period. From this screen, you can also configure some important parameters like how many connections the user can make per hour, how many queries the user can run per hour, how many update statements the user can run per hour, and the maximum number of connections the user can make at any time. Again, you should consider setting these parameters for user accounts based on your organization's security policy. The next tab shows a few roles dbForge Studio has defined for us. These are not MySQL roles, it's just a way of grouping together similar system-level privileges. For example, the DBA role will have most privileges, followed by a less privileged DB manager role, and so on. Each role will have different types of permissions attached to it. For simplicity, dbForge Studio shows a short description of the access granted to each role. The choice we make here will affect the way we see the next tab called Global Privileges. If we look at the Global Privileges tab for User 6, we can see it contains almost 2 dozen native MySQL privileges. None of these are selected at the moment. When any of the privileges are granted from this tab, it will grant some system-wide privileges. For example, checking the Select checkbox will give User 6 the permission to list all databases in the system. To see this, let's click on the checkbox for Select, and then click the Script Changes button at the top. A query window opens, and we can see the action would have the same effect of running an SQL command giving this privilege. Let's now go back to the Roles tab. Let's say we want to grant User 6 backup admin rights. Remember, we said there are no MySQL role called backup admin. It's just what dbForge Studio calls a set of permissions grouped together. We select the checkbox and click Script Changes again. This time, the query shows it will grant User 6 event, log tables, select, and show databases privileges. In other words, we could run these commands one by one, but the UI gives us a better option. If we now go back to the Global Privileges tab of the Security Manager, we can see a few of the checkboxes have been automatically selected for us. Okay, next we go to the Object Privileges tab. From here, you can assign permissions on individual databases and their objects. Let's say we want to grant User 6 select permission on a single table in My Test database. We select the database, expand the tables node, and then select the customers table. From the available privileges list, we only check the select option. If we now script this action, we can see the MySQL command for it, along with the previous command for global privilege. Finally, we have another tab called SSL. From here, we can specify the type of certificate a user will need to connect to an instance if encrypted communication has been enabled at the server level. To apply any changes made in the Security Manager, we have to click the Save button. Instead of saving the changes, let's check the rights of our root user. So, we click the root user under localhost folder in the user list. Security Manager asks if we want to save the changes for User 6. We say no, and then click on the Roles tab. You can see the root user has the DBA role along with all other roles. Under the Global Privileges tab, we can see all permissions are selected and the checkbox for with grant option is selected too. This means the root user can grant these privileges to any other user. There are no privileges explicitly selected under the Object Privileges tab, and that's because the root user has already system-wide access. So this was a brief demonstration of managing MySQL user security. We saw how we can check the existing user accounts in a MySQL instance, check a user account's privileges, and assign permissions to that user account, all from the command prompt. We then saw how dbForge Studio for MySQL can make the user management process much simpler and intuitive. DBAs can use the Security Manager tool to save time and effort instead of writing and running SQL commands manually. With 160 products, Devart is one of the top database companies in the world today. On average, Devart products are downloaded 37,000 times a month. Nearly 60% of Fortune 100 companies use Devart database tools. To know more about the company and its products, visit the website.